You hear a lot about eVTOLs these days. For one, that there are so many of these designs in the works. Some say 600. Joby Aviation seems to have a jump on all of them. So far, Joby's S4, a four-seat, six-rotor design, has flown 150 statute miles nonstop and demonstrated a 200 mile per hour top speed. I flew a Joby simulator in the company's Washington, D.C. office over terrain that simulates that of the Washington area.
So I'm going to give it a shot here. It's got six engines. This is the power control here, and this is the vertical control here. So I've just had a very brief lesson, and I'm not helicopter rated, so got to cut me some slack here, but here goes. So to get it into a hover, you just pull back on the vertical control and up you go, and I'll hover it at 60 feet and I'll let go. And it'll stay there because it's fly-by-wire. So to go up some more, you pull some more, there's 80 feet, let it go. Now we want to go forward, so we'll add some power and it'll stay at 80 feet. And I don't have to control the vertical part anymore. It's automatic. It's fly-by-wire. Okay, now we want to go up. So we'll raise the nose like 5 degrees. And that's 1,000 feet per minute. And I'll let go. And it climbs. That is cool. That's fly-by-wire. Okay, so we're still climbing at 750 feet per minute out over the water. Okay, so 104 knots. And then I'll bank it. And it won't go any more than 45 degrees because, again, it's got envelope protection and fly-by-wire is maintaining our altitude and airspeed. So it's obviously it's real easy to fly. All right, I'm going to bank back around. Okay, now I'm coming down. Keep slowing it down. I'll level it off. There's 80, 79. We need airport elevations 20, so I'm going to try and bring it into a hover at 60 feet. There's 60 feet, and I'm going to let it stabilize there. Let it go to I'm pulling back on the power. Okay, there's 0 knots. Okay, here we are. Hovered at 60. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, now I'm going to land it. Just by pushing it down a little and it'll come down. And we're on the ground.
Joby bought Uber Elevate with the idea of creating a ride-sharing service in the sky.
So the idea would be that you can open up the Joby app or even the Uber app, and on those apps you'll have a choice to pick your flight. And so you'll pick your flight and where you want to go to. The beginning of the journey, a car will come to your house and drive you to your nearest airport or your nearest heliport, and then the aircraft will be there waiting for you. You'll get on, you'll go on your flight, relatively short 15 or 20 minute flight, very close to where you want to be. Ideally, you're there and you can just walk to your location. If not, there's a car waiting to finish your trip for you. And that one button push is an end-to-end journey.
Joby's been quiet about all its progress, but don't be surprised if it's the first to go to market.
It has been a lot of work and effort to date. We have been typically pretty quiet about the progress we make, but we're really excited to get this out there for the world.
Tom Horne, AOPA pilot.